listen, today we are here, we're going to talk a little bit about entrepreneurship. Entrepreneurship, one of those two. Let me put on the Dr. Not a Dr. Juno glasses for a second. So listen, the beauty of entrepreneurship is it's problem solving. I mean, that's really the essence of it, which is also the essence of, like, engineering. And I mean, like, abstractly, it's also the essence of being a scientist. And part of the beauty of entrepreneurship is you're constrained only by your problem. Right? So a lot of times scientists are also constrained by their discipline. They're constrained by where they're getting their funding from, most of the time governments. So there's a lot of constraints in problem solving in specialized fields. Like being an engineer, you're constrained. You're only solving the problems that the clients bring to you. If you're in finance, if you're like an MBA, you're constrained to the problems of your firm. So it's a give and take though. There's the gift of the artistic aspect that entrepreneurship holds, but there's also the take that you don't have the security of a firm. You're venturing farther out into the chaos. You're taking more chaos and less order. An engineer likes order a little more than an entrepreneur. So in entrepreneurship, you don't have that back of any firm. So it's a little more artistic, but it's also the opportunity to build that firm. And that's the noble goal of entrepreneurship, is to be at a place where not only you solve a problem, but you can provide other people means. And what that looks like, ages 20 to 25, is this intermediary power leveling state before we take on the big kid world at 25. Now, this clip is Gary Vaynerchuk. He's playing in the big kid world. He's an entrepreneur. His goal is to buy the New York Jets. You know, we talked about the Pareto distribution, and we talk about people who are successfully getting all the stuff, or at that level of getting lots of the stuff. And a book called Rich Dad, Poor Dad talks about this too. He breaks down how the poor people make money either as employees, where they work for money, or as small business owners, where their business works for money. But the rich dad, he's either an entrepreneur, where he manages people who make him money, or he's an investor, where he manages money that makes money. And the entrepreneur investor, that's part of the secret to hacking the Pareto distribution and to getting all the wealth. So yeah, that's kind of cool too. I'm gonna run this clip and then I'll catch up with you later in the day. Peace.
I'm scared. I'm super scared. I'm scared because I know exactly what happens this month every year for the rest of time, or actually not the rest of time, hopefully this will end soon, but I'm scared. I'm scared because I know that there are so many of you that graduate this month and have no fucking idea what you want to do. And that's okay. Most people don't. You should not be stressed about that. I'm actually not scared about that. I'm scared that you don't realize that you're entering the greatest 5-year window of your life. If you are 22 years old and graduating from college, shit, if you're 22 years old and not graduating from college, if you are 22 years old, you are entering, first of all, some of the greatest years of your life, A, but B, this is the moment. Watch this video twice. If mama's watching this, send this to your daughter Sally right now, because you have to understand, this next 5-year window is when you don't go practical and safe. This is not the time to get the job mom wanted you to. This is not the time to try to maximize as much money so you can buy a fat whip. This is the time to realize that you have a 5-year window, and it's 3 for some, it's 8 for others, but this is a 5-year window for you to attack the life that you want to win, not because it's the secret or because the world's so zen, because it's fucking hard as shit out there. As a matter of fact, I'm probably more scared about your naivete to how hard it. Class is easy, right? What you've been doing for the last 16 years is easy. It's a fucking bullshit game. It's structured, it's easy. The world, this thing is hard. However, that contradicts what I'm gonna tell you right now, which is this is the best and easiest 5 years of your life, because this is when you need to attack what you love and what you want to do. Here's why. You don't have all the baggage. You may have college loans, respect, it's hard as shit. You may have the expectations of your parents, mentally hard, fake hard. You may have a lot of other things, but this is exactly when you can live with 4 roommates in a basement and eat fucking fast food. Do you understand? This is not when the baby's there, some of you have babies. This is not when you've been married and you promised. This is not when the world has sucked out all your dreams and hopes yet. You still got this window, and yet, so many of you are so hungry for short-term gains, like maximizing the job that paid you $3,000 more, but it's not as fun, but you want that $3,000. For what? For what? For a new iPhone? For what? You get to live life one time. And this is the time right now to understand what's actually happening and actually map your behavior to something that will impact you for the next 80 years. So promise me, all you youngsters that are watching this right now, in the fucking comments, because I'll jump in and talk to you. Promise me that you understand that the land grab of happiness starts right now. That you don't have to worry about getting that job. What you should do is go and travel and learn. Go and start that business that you've always wanted. Hook up with those three teammates and start that band you've always wanted. This is the time to be massively risk oriented. I know that this is when you're supposed to grow up and go see the world, but guess what? The world isn't what mommy and daddy told you. The world is exactly going to be what it's going to be, with or without the way you thought it was gonna be. A ton of shit is gonna change. The world changes every goddamn day. Right now, what you need to recognize is you can afford to. And not all of you, I'm sure somebody will leave a comment and say, I've got a loan. I get it, respect. But that loan is gonna be there whether you go and try to build something for yourself or not, one way or the other. And by the way, you can work at night. This is when you put in the 18 hours a day to make your life that you want happen. And again, because I'm scared, I can hear myself fucking talking. I'm not saying it's the secret, it's practicality. When you are in your early 20s, this is when you can grind at your highest levels because there isn't all the fucking baggage that comes across from life. It's harder for the 42-year-olds that are watching right now to listen to this advice. You can't just wake up tomorrow and be like, let's go, because little Sally has soccer fucking practice and because you've got a million other things that are holding you down. But boy, if you're lucky enough to be graduating today with not a fucking idea of what you're gonna do with your future, nobody's ever been luckier than you. Please recognize it.
Well, guys, things took a turn for the interesting. Check these cameras out. Look at them. Look at their eyeballs. Look at his eyes. Oh. His eyes are like mine. Three. Third floor. So listen, these f***ers had the audacity to say my two bags are too much. So I have to go put all my sh** into one bag. So yeah, we ended up in this place. I don't know. There's like a sauna, a shower, a hot tub. So we're doing good. We're about to head back to campus and start this next day. Yeah, boy. Let's get it. We're in for an adventure.